Transport regulators deploy an additional 42 buses along EDSA to keep up with increasing passenger demand. But this deployment is only on a trial basis and will end on January 16th. The extra units come from bus companies, which are not part of the EDSA carousel currently plying the highway. Philippine Senate Minority Leader Coco Pimentel opposes the plan to import onions. He brands the move as ill-timed since Filipino farmers are close to harvesting their produce. Instead of importing onions, he urges the Agriculture Department to go after hoarders and price fixers to prevent the supposed market manipulation of agricultural products. The Armed Forces of the Philippines, meanwhile, says it supports Gavis's appointment as Defense Secretary. AFP spokesperson Colonel Medel Aguilar says Gálvez, being a former AFP chief of staff and a peace advocate, has the capabilities that will help him attain the military's mission. Aguilar also clarified there was no issue in the turnover of power from General Bacaro to General Centino, despite rumors of a destabilization plot.
It was a very smooth transition from the outgoing to the incoming command, chief of staff. And the Armed Forces of the Philippines, being a professional organization, will support whoever is designated by the President as command, as chief of staff. Ito po ay parte ng ating tradisyon at saka siyempre officers coming to.
President Marcos orders the Justice Department to continue the release of persons deprived of liberty who are qualified for parole. During a cabinet meeting this morning, Marcos said the move will help decongest the country's correctional facilities. The president also backed the Bureau of Corrections plan to transfer criminals convicted of heinous crimes to an Alcatraz type of prison. The Justice Department says over 3,000 inmates were set free in 2022. On to more news, the Supreme Court strikes down the joint marine seismic undertaking between state-owned oil corporations of China, Vietnam, and the Philippines, involving 142,000 square meters in the South China Sea. The Supreme Court en banc voted 12-2. The tripartite agreement is among China National Offshore Oil Corporation, Vietnam Oil and Gas Corporation, and Philippine National Oil Company. The court ruled the deal is unconstitutional for allowing wholly owned foreign corporations to participate in the exploration of the country's natural resources without observing the constitutional safeguards. The Constitution reserves exploration, development, and utilization of natural resources to full control of the state. The petition was filed by former Bayan Muna Party List Representative Satur Ocampo and Teddy Casino last 2018. The government has argued that the deal is not illegal because it only involves pre-exploration activities. But the court ruled the intent of the agreement is to discover petroleum, which is tantamount to exploration. Associate Justice Samuel Garland wrote, the decision, which was concurred in by Chief Justice Alexander Gismundo and 10 other associate justices.
China retaliates against South Korea and Japan's travel curbs on its citizens. Beijing suspended the issuance of short-term visas to South Korean and Japanese travelers. It says the measures will be adjusted if Seoul and Tokyo lift what it calls discriminatory restrictions on China. South Korea and Japan are among the long list of nations that tighten border measures against travelers from China due to its new COVID outbreak.